Hi, I'm Maria Ingold. I'm a CTO in video technology. I'm here at Connected Media IP at the NAB Show 2019. I am joined by Renato Bonomini, the VP of Global Pre-Sales for ContentWise. Mm-hmm. Can you tell us a bit about ContentWise first?
Sure. Well, thank you for hosting me. So ContentWise, we work in the personalization space. So what we believe as a company is that in order to make your service compelling to users, personalization is key. Now, it has become more and more evident over the years that that has become where the user experience is so important that users are going to stick to your service because of a good user experience. So the role that we play is we enable our partners, our clients, to be in control of their user experience of their users through a better user experience, a more rich pool, more meaningful, better metadata, and overall end-to-end user experience.
That's great. So what are you looking forward to most at this show now that you're here?
It's always a great opportunity to find out where the industry is going, what other players are working on, what other customers are looking at, and we have a lot of people coming in, and especially this year, we have a lot of people that we didn't know about that are coming in and coming up with questions about where the industry is going, but also they are actually saying so. So most of the time, actually, we hear from people that come at our booth and they ask, oh, can you do this? Can you do that? Or we have this problem, or we're trying to make users stick more. We're trying to make more rich, more meaningful user experiences.
Yes.
We have this metadata problem. How do we make data available right away? How do we personalize the user experience one-to-one? So it's a great opportunity to find out not only what other vendors are doing, now you have all of the same ones in the same place, that's great, but also what are really companies that use the technologies are looking for to make the user experience better. At the end, we say that the content is king in this space. We also found out that metadata is really the queen, and we want to make sure that the queen is happy.
Yes.
So that's a space where we play, and we find more and more every year that the user experience is really the heart of everything and has to be supported by metadata, content. You have to have great content, you have to have a great user experience, and when you put the context in place, those are the three ingredients that you put together to really deliver a superior product.
Yes, absolutely. So user experience is one of those key differentiators, and your customers are definitely coming to talk with you more about that. Is there anything really key to that?
This has been changing, and I believe that nowadays everyone is familiar with the traditional recommendation technologies. That all kids that come out of college who have done that as a pet project during college build a recommender engine. Who hasn't done it? I mean, there are even Coursera classes on how to build your own recommender engine. So that's why, you know, we started 10 years ago as a recommender engine. And out of that experience, we found that there's so much more to make a compelling user experience than a carousel that says, recommended for you. That was like 10 years ago. Now, companies realize that. So nowadays, what they're coming up is, you know, we're past that. That's given. That's already in place. What can we do more? So the space that we found that is a very interesting challenge and a real problem that we want to help companies is understanding that one-to-one relationship. A lot of solutions out there that are available today on the market address the market segmentation. Marketing people are very familiar with segmentation of users. Now, the big spenders, the top users, big pockets, that's a very well-known set of technologies and understanding and knowledge has been around for a while, not just in the video space, pretty much everywhere. So out of that, we see that where the direction is going is to take that idea. Why not, instead of having a group, why not to make it a one-to-one personalized experience? You're no longer a person that belongs to a group. You log on to a service and you get a certain user experience because you belong to a group? Yes, that's a kind of a given now. Now you log into a service and you find what's relevant to you, both in terms of content. So you see, for example, carousels that contain content that are sorted by your profile, but your history, what you like best is first, but also the containers in the page are also personalized. That's the direction that we're seeing, and actually it resonates extremely well with the companies that we're working in. I've been asking more and more to take more control as an operator of the user experience on a one-to-one base.
Yes.
And we do find that that works from a user experience perspective only if it is working together with, you know, that's a king, the content. Make sure the queen is happy, so metadata. That's another crucial area where we do find that other industry has been doing extremely well.
Yes.
I've been with the companies for more than 10 years, and I've also worked in other business units of the company. ContentWise is part of the Movir Group. And I've seen in other industry that the management of data is much more mature than the media space. So there's a lot of opportunity to improve how metadata is managed. For example, we do see that a lot of companies are struggling into collecting data from different places, making it available in a single place, making it available to all of the other services that need it in-house, but also to make sure that the quality of the metadata is sufficient to have that rich experience that everyone is expecting. I'm looking at a movie, I'm looking at a TV series. Yes, title, genre, year, release date, duration, those are helpful. What are the actors doing? Who they're married to? What are their movies they starred on? Why are they famous? Maybe you're watching a movie and you like movies that are always starring a rock star. So that kind of information for metadata is crucial to enrich the user experience so that not only you find content quickly, that's improving the user experience. You find what you're looking for in a quicker way, but when you find it, you feel like it's a rich and culturally enhancing experience. So that's why you need to look at both the metadata space from the content perspective and the user experience from a UI point of view.
So we've got content is king. And a lot of money being spent on content by places like Netflix. We've got metadata is queen. Is there anything else that is a differentiator that you think is key?
I would say the third player is likely context. In order to personalize the experience, you have to shape your service so that it knows the intention of the user. Mm. It's great that you log on to a service and exactly what you watched last week. That's great. But the context is what actually makes the service aware that the user in that moment is actually having a specific intention. Perhaps because the user is using a specific device, or perhaps the user is, for example, out of network, or the user is watching TV at nighttime. So the experience must change according to the context of the user. Where is the user located? Sometimes it's purely for licensing reason. If you're in a region that titles are not available, well, that should be considered, that's obvious. But also, perhaps, the way that people consume content in one region is different than another. So that's where you actually take the segmentation part and you use those groups to even further personalize. So when you put the three things together, they use the content, original content, licensed content, the user itself, and the context, and you put them together, that's where you can actually govern all of the three things that makes that user experience so compelling that users are going to want to stick to your service. There are so many services out there, they're all great, so why should a user keep using your specific service? Because they think, wow, that service understands me. When I go there, I find what I'm looking for easily, quickly, and I always find something interesting.
Yeah, so content, user experience, and context.
Context.
That's great. One last thing. I noticed that your mission is to be the single point of control in charge of the entire digital discovery and consumption experience.
Mm-hmm.
What exactly does that mean to you and your customers?
So there are a lot of solutions today that allow you to do separate things. Mm-hmm. You have targeting solutions that take the UI and display differently according to segmentations. There are solutions that do recommendations. There are solutions that do, for example, targeted advertisement. There are solutions that enhance the metadata. So what we do as a company is we try to put together all these functionalities in a single control tower so that you don't have teams that are working separately toward the same goal. For example, we work with one of the largest TV operators in the States, and one of the things that they're doing, they have UX people working together with the UI people, I'm using a lot of jargon, together with the content planning people. They're working together to understand that when a user logs into a service and they search for something or they browse the app itself to look for content, there is a single view on how your service behaves, from what content is available, where it is available, how it is made available, how easy it is to find it. So what we want to achieve is something that enables all of this team to work together and control how actually the user experience is delivered to the user from a single place. So what we say is that, no, we put you in the main seat in the control tower so that you control the user experience of the users. User of this kind, or no, Jack, Bob, a single person get a specialized user experience, and you determine the recipe. Now, in a culinary kind of analogy, you can think of a menu at the restaurant where you go in and you look at the menu, and the menu tell, hey, Renato, I know it's you, I know what you like. This is what I tell you you should be eating. And, you know, usually don't feel like dessert, so we're just going to skip the first and second. So the idea is that you have this great book of recipes that use your ingredients, your content. Your ingredients and your recipes are your secret recipe, your secret and magic sauce. We help you use that secret sauce and to make it so that that menu for that user feels so personal that they come back to you. They don't even want a menu. They know that you get there and, hey, just, well, you tell me. That's how it should feel for a user when they actually use our service. So we want to be in that space, and we do find that making king happy is great. Making queen happier is even better. Consider the contest. You put the three things together, and that's what we see as a winning factor. And we do see results coming out from some of our most enlightened partners that are working in that direction.
Well, here's to that secret sauce. Thank you so much for joining us here at Connected Media IP.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, I hope to see you again next year and find out more about what you've been up to.
All right. Thank you again.